Welcome back, everyone. I think you're gonna really enjoy this video. After a lot of digging, I found 13 really cool Chrome extensions that I think you should know about. And a couple of these are pretty well known, but I'm pretty sure that most of these will be new to you, and they definitely were for me. And if you want to know about even more extensions at the end of this video, I'll put a link to the previous video I made about this with some other cool ones. And of course, before we begin, I'm going to give a quick shout out to my Instagram account. I try to only post quality content on there. If you want to check it out, my username is just @TheoJoe. So let's get started. Starting off with number one, we have a very cool extension called Turn Off the Lights. What this does is when you're watching a video on YouTube or Vimeo or really any other website, it will darken the screen around the video. So maybe you're watching a long video and don't necessarily want to go full screen, this will let you tune out any other distractions on the page. And for an extension that's so simple, there is a surprising amount of options, such as how dark it gets, the ability to also blur the surrounding parts, exclude certain parts of the YouTube page from being darkened, such as the like button, and a bunch of other stuff. Definitely one to check out. Next up, it's Chrome User Agent Switcher, which is actually an extension made by Google. Some of you may know what this does right off the bat, but if you don't know what a user agent switcher is, it basically changes the fingerprint of your browser, so websites will think you're using something else, like Firefox or Safari. This can be useful for those annoying websites that might block you because you're not using a supported browser, even if it's Chrome and fully capable. Or maybe for some reason you want to pretend like you're using a mobile web browser, like developing a website, you can switch to iOS or Android as well. There are several to choose from, but I should point out that this doesn't actually change anything about your browser itself and doesn't offer any privacy. It simply changes what browser you tell the website you're using. Moving on, we have Honey. This one is a really cool idea where whenever you go and buy something online, once you get to the checkout page, this extension will automatically try several coupon codes to see if there are any discounts that you didn't know about. It apparently supports hundreds of online stores, and while it obviously isn't going to find a working coupon every time, it is nice every once in a while you'll randomly see that you saved money because of some coupon you didn't even know about. So you just kind of set it and forget it, and you might save money later and get a nice surprise. Okay, number four is a really interesting one made by Google called Long Descriptions in Context Menu. I didn't know this, but apparently it's possible for websites to embed long descriptions of images, typically used for someone who is visually impaired and has a screen reader, so it tells them what the image is. This is different from alt text that you can see by hovering over an image, and unless you know about these long descriptions, then they're totally invisible. And so, well, like the title suggests, this extension makes it so you can right-click an image and view the long description of it if it has one. Or if you don't want to check every time, it can outline images that do have one so you can see right off the bat. Now, these long descriptions are very rare and probably not really useful to most, but I thought it was something that you might at least want to know about. Next up, we have Chrome Connectivity Diagnostics, yet another one made by Google. Though technically it's a Chrome app, not an extension, but whatever. The title is self-explanatory. This app allows you to run a simple test of your internet connection through Chrome. So if your internet seems to be really slow or it's not working at all, you can run this and it should be able to tell you where things are going wrong, whether certain ports are being blocked, if the DNS servers are working, and a bunch of other stuff as well. This is certainly a good one to have just in case, I think. All right, six is Grammarly, an extension that has actually gotten pretty popular. In simple terms, it's a spell checker, but obviously there's a little bit more to it. Whenever you type something in on a website, whether it's to post on Twitter or Facebook or an email, it will automatically scan the message to see if there's anything you might want to change. And it won't autocorrect, just tell you. You'll see if it's working because in the bottom right of the form, you'll see a little symbol and it will be green or red depending on what it found. This is one to consider if you're prone to doing a lot of typos. Numero 7, Traffic Light. No, this has nothing to do with driving, but rather it's a security app made by Bitdefender, which you may be familiar with. The idea for this is it just runs in the background and scans any websites you visit for malicious elements. But the cool thing about this is if a website only has some malicious parts, it will only block those parts. That way you aren't totally blocked from going to the site, but you shouldn't be exposed either. By default, it also scans search results, but you can turn that off if you don't like seeing the check marks it adds to all the results. I turned that off personally. Also, it will let you know if there are any tracking cookies or elements on the site, like from Facebook or something like that. I think it's a good way to supplement your current antivirus software, which you should all have. Okay, moving on. Here's one you probably haven't heard of. It's called Forest. It's a productivity app with a unique concept. Instead of just blocking distracting websites, it turns it into a game. When you need to get work done, you start a timer and plant a virtual tree. As the timer continues, this tree grows until the timer ends, and then you add that tree to your collection because it's fully grown. But here's the thing, if you go on any distracting websites that you've blocked, the tree dies and you have to start it over. Now there's also a mobile app which does the same thing except for apps instead of websites. That has a lot more features and you can sync the browser extension to it. And plus it does also show you an actual virtual forest of the trees that you've grown. It's kind of cool. But to sync the two, you do need the premium version, which is $2, not that much. You might still want to look into that as well. Next, number 9. This is really just useless, but kind of funny. And it's called Tabby Cat. Basically it changes Chrome. So whenever you create a new blank tab, it will show you a cat. It's a different one each time, and you'll get random drops of gifts and accessories you can use to customize the cats. And so far I've gotten a fishbone, which I think is the starting item, and a hat. But yeah, it doesn't really do anything. It's just kind of a fun little extension. You might like it. Okay, so with all of these extensions you have, this next one will come in real handy. It's called Extensity. And the purpose is to make it easy to enable and disable Chrome apps on the fly. Not uninstall them, mind you, just turn them off. You just click on the icon and it will show you a whole list of extensions and apps, and you just click on them to toggle them on and off. The nice thing about this is normally to disable extensions, you have to navigate to the extensions page in Chrome, find it in the list, and click the checkbox. And a reason you might do this is so you can keep lots of extensions you like installed, but maybe there are a few that you rarely use, but don't want to completely uninstall it. Now, you can just disable it so it doesn't take up any system resources all the time, and whenever you do need it, just enable it. Very useful. Number 11. I think everyone's gonna like this one. It's called BehindTheOverlay. Have you ever gone to a webpage that has something you're looking for, but all of a sudden you get a pop-up blocking you from seeing the site unless you sign up for an account or something like that? It's really frustrating because you can see the information right there, but it won't let you see the whole thing. Well, this extension fixes that. You can click the extension icon and it removes the overlay, letting you see the web page as normal. This will also work with overlays trying to get you to sign up for email newsletters, the ones with nearly impossible to find close buttons like that. Keep in mind though, this will not work if the website is coded so that the content is not actually shown behind the overlay. Even if you remove the overlay in that case, it might only show you a small part because the rest was never there to begin with. Still, I think I'll find myself using this a lot. Coming near the end, number 12 is Showgoers for Netflix. This one is actually awesome. It lets you sync up Netflix shows and movies with friends so you can all watch the same thing at the same time. How it works is once you log into Netflix and start playing something, you then click on the glasses icon at the top right. You then have the option to start a new watch party or even browse public ones made by other people. You get a few options and then it gives you a link to share with anyone to let them join the chat room. Obviously, everyone watching has to have this extension and an active Netflix account for this to work. It's not like it creates the stream, it just keeps you all synced up. Really neat. And finally, 13 is Aha Music Identifier. It's basically like Shazam or SoundHound, except as an extension. where it can identify songs playing on a website or in a video you're watching or something like that. If there's any audio playing in a tab, you just click the icon and it starts listening. And you'd probably need about 10 seconds of sample time for it to work. If it finds it, it'll show you the name of the song and links to where you can listen to it, like YouTube or Spotify. Obviously, you can just use your app on your phone to identify it, but then you have to grab your phone, go to the app, hold it up to the speakers. It's kind of a pain, whereas here it's very simple. The only thing though that I should point out is that when you install it, Chrome tells you that this app will try to start up with Windows even if Chrome is closed. I don't like apps that do that, so you can prevent that from happening by going to the Chrome settings, then Advanced, and then under System, disable the option that says continue running background apps when Google Chrome is closed. And then you should be set. So there you have it, 13 Chrome extensions you might not have known about, but hopefully found cool. If I missed any really cool ones, be sure to let me know and everyone else in the comments. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here, like even more extensions. And if you want to subscribe, I make a few new videos every week. And also consider enabling notifications or else YouTube might not show you them anyway. But anyway, as usual guys, I'm looking forward to hearing from you. So thanks for watching, I'll see you next time, and have a good one.